Hey guys, welcome to my channel and welcome back to another faith planner, big happy planner, plan with me. It's late at night and I just decided to go ahead and do this because I need to get it done and because I'm just, you know, not doing anything else right now and not sleeping right now. So, what I normally do is read a couple of scriptures, and also before I do any of that, I tell you what this is for. I use this for my scripture writing plan, and I make a new scripture writing plan every month, and I also share it with you guys on both of my channels. I share it. I also share it on Instagram and I believe it goes on Pinterest from my Instagram, but anyway, so that is where I get my script writing plans. I create them by looking through my Bible and I pray and ask God to help me figure out what to do the plan on, and then I figure out which scriptures work for what I feel like I'm supposed to be doing. And this month I did not start as soon as I should have, but that's okay. I got it done and I'll be showing you that soon, but I do that. That's what this is for, blah blah, blah, all these words. And this is where I do my prayer list. And used to be this was like so full, but I decided, because I have gotten so many YouTube friends who entrust me to pray for them, that I just don't have space on this little spot to write all their names. So I have another list that I write that on, and then I just write YouTube friends in there, and then I, you know, that way I'm reminded. And then I write one thing that I'm grateful for throughout the week. So I'm going to read a couple of scriptures, and this week the thing was getting things organized, which really, it wasn't really exactly organizing, it was purging some things. But it was getting things more organized to get rid of those things. But anyways, I'm going to read a couple of the scriptures. This one was on freedom, the scripture writing plan that we're on right now for July. So let's see. I don't know where to even start. I'll read Romans 6:22. But now, since you have been liberated from sin and have become enslaved to God, you have your fruit, which results in sanctification, and the end is eternal life. Now, that does not mean like slave ownership or being a slave the way that we know it all over the place. Honestly, there's been slavery everywhere, but I mean, it's still going on to this day, but in the U.S., we are popular for it, and it's a very bad thing to be popular for, and it's something that I absolutely hate, and the fact that I live in the South and was born and raised in the South makes it even harder sometimes, because people look at me, and they hear my accent, and they think that I'm that way, and there is zero chance that I would have ever owned a slave. And also, my family couldn't have afforded one, because we did not come from money at all. But either way, I don't even know if my family was here when all that was going on. I don't know when my family came to the States, but either way, this means that since you have become saved, since God has saved you, you are now his child. You are now set to be sanctified and to be cleaned up and cleansed and to be with him one day. You know, I'm not explaining this very well. Maybe it's because it's late at night. Maybe it's because I am still dealing with my mouth. I don't know if I talked about it on my other videos, because my brain, I don't know. Anyway, I have to have a root canal next week. So, yeah. Not fun. So, I'm on antibiotics now because of it. Because, yeah. Anyway, so if I'm confusing, please forgive me and stick with me, because at least, you know, maybe you'll see some pretty stickers. Okay, so that's that one. I don't even know where I'm going with any of this today. I'm so sorry. 1 Corinthians 9:1, Am I not free? Am I not an apostle? Have I not seen Jesus our Lord? Are you not my work in the Lord? Okay, that's a lot of questions. And the reason why I'm wanting to read that one is because it's something we should ask ourselves whenever we start feeling the pull to go back to where we have been, whenever we start getting criticized for who we are as Christians. Paul is saying these things. He's saying, am I not free? Am I not an apostle? Have I not seen Jesus our Lord? Are you not my work in the Lord? Now, I don't remember exactly who he was talking to. I've got it pulled up here. This says in verse 2, even if others think I am not an apostle, I certainly am to you. You yourselves are proof that I am the Lord's apostle. He's talking to the people in the Corinth church. And, you know, Paul was Saul. He was a very bad man. He was killing Christians. He was not anyone that you would think that God would call, that God would use. But of all the people, God chose him and brought him to salvation so that he could reach others. And now most of the New Testament, Paul wrote it. So God used him in a mighty way. So whenever we are thinking, or whenever somebody's persecuting us and saying, well, if you're a Christian, you shouldn't do that. Well, first of all, don't be giving me your convictions. I don't live by yours. You know, that's the thing you need to think. But you need to say, am I not free? Did God not save me? Am I not an apostle? Am I not someone that God wants to use? Have I not seen Jesus our Lord? And no, I have not physically seen Jesus, but I have seen him work in my life. And are you not my work in the Lord? Okay, so now that part might be a little bit different for you. It might be a little different for me because the person we might be talking to or the person that's criticizing us, they may not be anything that God has used us to bring to him, but there could be a time whenever he would or could or does. So anyway, I don't know. I just feel like that would be a good one. And whenever he says, am I not free? That's freedom in Christ. That's not freedom as in, you know, Paul was a slave or anything. That's freedom in Christ. That's because God has set him free from the bondage of sin. And yes, we still sin as Christians. We still sin. Everybody does. We try not to. And nobody's perfect. And you shouldn't beat yourself up if you make mistakes. Just ask forgiveness and go on about your business, you know. Go on about your life. Don't let others condemn you and make you feel like you're not worthy of God's love and his affection and of him taking care of you. So, okay. Now I've got my pages down and I'm not going to start decorating them yet because I want to show you this. First, I've got to get my sticker page out of the way. Okay, this is the current scripture writing plan. We have just a few more days from the 26th to the 31st. But we will be starting the new plan on the 1st, which will be in this week because we're doing the 26th through the 1st. Sunday is the 1st. And this time, I just decided to do a scripture writing plan on joy. And I changed how I did the format. I kind of like this a little bit better. This is what I typed up on the side, and honestly, I should have proofread it. I guess I'll do that now. I wrote out, we all need some joy in our lives. There's only one place to find it. If we are seeking joy through this world, we will be lacking it all of our days. So I decided to make a writing plan. I should have wrote a scripturing plan, but that's okay. A writing plan to help us know where to look when we are struggling. Now, this is not a full, complete list of verses in the Bible that talk about joy. I don't have enough days in a month to have all of those scriptures. This is only, well, it's actually more than 31 because there's some that have two. But with these that have two, if I didn't put two there, then the one wouldn't make as much sense. And so I decided to just do that. And I try my best to go ahead and put them in order of the books of the Bible. The first one that I took from this time is in Psalms, and then the last one is in 3 John. But yeah, I don't, this is not an all-inclusive every single subject, every single scripture in the Bible. On the subject, it is just, some of them is 31, well, technically more than 31, but it's 31 days worth of writing on joy. I did use the English Standard Version Bible to find this, to, you know, find the scriptures. But as I have said before, I'm not going to argue about the different versions. There are some that I would never read, but you can go back and look at the root of where the words come from and all those kinds of things. You can use your concordance and dictionaries and all those things, and you can find that scriptures from different Bibles line up. You just have to know how to study, and it's not making things up. It is actually comparing the words, comparing the verses. And I do that sometimes on, I have talked about different verses on my other channel whenever I do my weekly Bible study, and, you know, compared verses, but it's not something that I'm willing to argue about, because honestly, I just want people to be in the Bible. I want them to be in the Word. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. I have found out what these tweezers are called. They're reverse tweezers. Because normally you would squeeze to close, these you squeeze to open. So I like reverse tweezers. I talked about my tweezers on one or both of my other videos. So like I said, the 26th of July through the 1st of August. And this year is just flying by. Sometimes I look at it and I think, oh, well, maybe that's a good thing, because maybe we'll get rid of some of this horrible stuff that's going on and things will get better. But that's not happening. 2020 didn't ever change much. And, you know, the world's just getting worse. And if you are here because this is a big happy planner, not because it's a faith planner, and you don't want to hear me talk about the Bible and things, I'm sorry. Well, not really, I'm not. That's what this is for. I do have two other planners that I do use that have, they're just like, one of them is my YouTube planner for my, both of my channels, and the other one is for my home stuff. So one of them is a happy planner, the other one's not, but still, if you don't like this kind of thing, maybe mute me, watch it anyway, and then, you know, go watch my other ones. I don't know. But I'm pretty sure that everyone who watches me, if you've watched any on my other channel, or if you watched me long on here, if you've watched any of my big happy planners, you know I'm a Christian, so you know I'm going to talk about God sometimes. And I'm not sorry for that. So, not trying to be offensive, because God is not offensive, but, you know, people get offended about water. They just do. They get offended about everything. So, I got this from Hobby Lobby. No, I did not pay $20 for it. That's what it says. But I got it on sale. They used to have 40% off coupons. I got this a long time back. I have another one as well. But, I've used some of this one. So, I pulled it back out. I haven't used it in a long time. I think I've actually used some of the other one too. But what I wanted to do, there is a section in here that has some oranges and purples. It's like flowers and stuff. And I don't know how much of like the Christian words and stuff I'm going to be using. We'll see. But where did that go? That was the whole reason I pulled this book out. There it is. There's some of it. But I don't know how much. I mean, I know I'm going to use some of this, but I don't know how much. Why did I think it had purple in it? Am I dreaming? Why did I feel like it had purple? Maybe because that one does. Anyway, I just wanted florals. I wanted colors. I wanted pretty stuff. And, you know, we will see. Which, there's not as much floral in there as I thought. But there's other things. There's cactus. There's the colors are there. So, I don't know. We'll see what I'm going to do. And go from there. But I don't know why I was thinking there was purple. I mean, there is a little bit in the butterfly. In one of the butterflies. So, that's why I had my purple and orange out. But, I don't know now. I may do it anyway. I have the green and stuff over here. But then, there's so much green in these. It's going to which ones I use. And I also have this orange looking... I don't know what the difference in those two. All of these came from So Cute Planner. All of these that I'm showing you right now. So, I don't know if she still got them, but I think she does. So, let's see. What am I going to do first? I was going to put the purple up there, but now that I'm thinking about it, I think I'm just going to use this color up here at the top because there's not a lot of purple. So, let's just do this one. I went down too far. I don't know why I feel like I have to be explaining myself more tonight, why I'm just saying some of the stuff I'm saying about, you know, like, you can mute me and stuff. I don't know. Which, this channel is rather small. And it's, okay, I started this channel because I felt like all my planner stuff was getting lost on my other channel. And I kind of didn't feel like I was having the time to do everything I wanted since I had so many videos going up. And I didn't want to do two videos on the same day. I just didn't want to do that. And I have done that. But I just didn't want to do that anymore. I didn't feel like that was fair to my viewers. That maybe they weren't interested in the planner stuff, but they just still watched it just because they wanted to support me. And I don't know if anybody actually did that, but I know that I have done that before. Whenever there's a channel that I really enjoy, I want to support that channel. I will go ahead and watch something even if I'm not super interested. Now, I may not watch it like super close. I may just let it play in the background of something else I'm doing in my life. But I still watch it even though it may not be something that I'm interested in. Like, there have been times that there's different things that I'm not into. Like, I can't even think of anything now. Like, how to do certain things with babies and stuff. I'm not into that. I've done that. My babies are grown. So, but I'd watch it anyway because the lady I was watching, I wanted to support her channel and I really liked her, you know. So I would watch that video even though I had no use for it. You know what I'm saying? That kind of thing. And I'm very grateful for anyone who does that for me as well. But I didn't want to feel like I had to do something like that. I didn't want to feel like that, you know, I didn't want other people to feel like they had to do that just to support my channel. Because, I don't know, I just did. And I might be wrong. I might be completely wrong. And, I don't know. Plus, another thing, which I still have some people that I'm subscribed to over there on the other channel that are planner girls, but I had noticed that I had not been getting many suggestions for new planner girls. And I was like, oh, is planning dying on YouTube? Is it just not a thing? Is it just, you know, certain people doing it? Well, whenever I started this channel, I started getting different suggestions. And now I found some really sweet ladies that I watch who are awesome planner girls. Now, I've seen a few that I can do without, so I just don't watch those. I don't like a lot of foul language and stuff. To each his own. I mean, you hear it everywhere you go, but I'm not gonna choose to watch that, so I don't. I'm gonna do something that I saw somebody else do recently. I may make a mistake, I may cry, I may hate that I did this, but I'm gonna cut this sticker. Okay, I did it. Okay, so what I'm gonna do with it is I'm gonna put part of it over here on here. I'll do it like this. On this side. Now this is not exactly what she did, because she was cutting them down at the bottom and stuff. But you guys know I don't take up a lot of my space. Okay, that does not look horrible. I'm not, you know, beat myself up about doing it. Also, this says, the Lord is my shepherd. I was kind of scared whenever I did that. This one says, God is stronger than my circumstances. I feel like I'm all over the place with this video. I don't feel... I'm not on any weird narcotics or anything. I'm only on antibiotics, so it's not the medicine. I think it's just my brain is not happy with the fact that I have to have things done. And I keep having these weird thoughts about... I mean, I've had root canal before. But that doesn't make me like it. Okay, so I would normally put one over here since I put one over there. But I'm going to do something just a little different than I would normally do. Maybe I won't. Maybe I'll see if I can find some more flowers or something. I thought there were more in here, but maybe not. I mean, there's like this. That would work for one of my spots. It says glorious. I could put that here and still have plenty of room to write. So that page is kind of done. But I need some for those places. And I haven't brought any foil in except up here. So maybe I'll bring this in. It says God with us, which normally I would put that on like Christmas time or something. I don't know. But that's okay. I've got to figure out something for this one. And I want to kind of do something I did here, right there. But I don't want anything that's like too big. I do like that. I was kind of scared of doing that, but I did it anyway. I feel like I'm all over the place. I feel like maybe, you know, the thing that I say, I don't want to offend people, but then again, you know, sometimes if you're offended by some of the stuff I say, maybe it's because you're not, you don't think like me or something. And that's normal life, not just on YouTube, because I have had times when people were like not happy with me because of things I said or my thoughts. I mean, people in my family, even not family that live in my house mostly. I'm gonna put that there. I think that's cute and it matches with the other things going on. I'd like to maybe find one for over there, but then that's so close to it that I don't know. But I feel like sometimes whenever we are so worried about offending people, we won't do the things that we're supposed to do. And sometimes I just don't want to deal with that kind of stuff. I don't want to deal with, I don't know, feeling like I have to be some certain way, I guess. This is love each other as I have loved you, but that is so big. I think I'm not going to use that. I think it's just too big. And that is one I am not willing to cut at all. Because, I mean, why would you cut words? That would look weird. Maybe this one, but then it... Oh, it's the last page, too. Let's see. It says blessed on there. Oh, there goes my... It's probably not even close to the middle, but... I think that's okay. Kind of want to move that one and put something like that one there. Because down here I can put a little bit more. Yes, I know I said that I filled up so much with my scripture, I mean with my other stuff. I know. But I feel like it'll be okay. I do have my other list. That's my master list of people I pray for or things I pray for. That one says redeemed, which you guys can probably see that. Maybe. I don't know. Can you see that? And I think that will be all unless I can find something to go up there, which I don't see anything small enough. Because I see plenty of like squares and stuff, but I don't have any like box stickers on here today, so I don't want a box sticker. So I think maybe I'll do this one. It says true love. Nope, it's too big. Not unless maybe I can move my butterflies down a little bit. And then put it right there, maybe. I don't know. That maybe is that. That just doesn't work, does it? It doesn't feel right. And I just mush that thing down. It doesn't. The heart just doesn't work. I need another gold words like this one. Honestly, that would be what I need to anchor that corner, I think, a little bit better. This one says love. And it is a square, but it's a clear square. Ah! It's a clear square, so it's a little bit different. You can't tell as much as a square. And... I kind of wish I hadn't put that pray there because I have another one that says pray. But that's okay. I'm not going to worry about that. Alright, I'm going to let that be. And get my scripture writing plan. Put my big old Caesars back. This is one of the only planners that I kind of stick to the same situation because I don't want to take up too much space in it with writing. I meant with stickers because I need it for writing. Now this day is actually Jeff and my 25th anniversary, which we're not going to get to do anything because he has to work. We're going to do something later. Colossians 3:11. Okay, 2 Thessalonians 3:1. Did I even spell Thessalonians right? I have to always check myself. 1 Peter 2:16. Revelation 1:5. Revelation 6:15. Revelation 13:16. Okay, and now we got to get the other one, which is Psalms 5:11. Okay, so I'm going to put these. This one I'm be done with, which I do keep them. And honestly, I don't have to print them out. The only reason I do it is to show you guys. So I don't even have to print them out each week. I just do for that one purpose. Or, well, I don't do it every week. I do it once a month. But anyway, I can't speak English. I'm going to put all this over here. And put these things where they go so I can get them out of my way, because for some reason I'm so discombobulated. I feel like this whole entire video might be a wreck. And put these back where they go. Now, I can put this where it goes. And this is the current week which we're in, which I still have 2 days to write, and my thankful thought. And that is the way it's going to look for this time. If you are interested in the scripture writing plan, it is in my link tree down below. It will be at the top, and all the old ones are at the bottom. It's also on my blog, which is also on my link tree. And on my other channel, Mama Cat's Home, I have it on my community page. I don't know if I can put it on my discussion page on here, because I don't have a community page yet, because I don't have 1,000 subscribers. But if I can put it on there, I will. But I mean, it's going to be in the description for you to be able to go check it out. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you did enjoy this. I hope you were not offended by anything that you shouldn't be. I don't know. Anyway, I'm going to shush. I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't have videoed tonight. Maybe I just should have just kept my mouth shut and just decided not to do this. But I'm going to go for now. Maybe come back next time and see that I'm not absolutely insane. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button. If you like my channel, go ahead and subscribe. Hit the bell so you're notified when I upload. Leave me a comment down below. Am I crazy or am I crazy? How you been doing, and what do you do if you have something you don't expect that kind of freaks you out a little bit, even though you know you've gone through it before and you were fine. Thank you again for watching, and remember, don't take any wooden nickels, and be sweet.